Lesson 8. Today we will review parts of the body, the pharmacy, telling time, new, getting sick, at the doctor's office, culture tip, health insurance, and conversation about names and culture. So, do you know your body parts? ¿Conoces tus partes del cuerpo? Do you know your body parts? Yeah. Aide, what is number one?
Hola, el face, la cara.
So, no es tan específico. That's good. So, cara is face. Yes. Uh-huh. But no es una de las opciones. It's not one of the options. See the options here on the left? La izquierda, on the left?
Yeah. El, oh, what? ¿Quiere que le diga el elbow?
Not elbow. Cabeza. How do you say cabeza?
Oh, hair?
Hair es cabello o pelo.
Pelo.
es una palabra un poco parecido a hair.
Sí, sí suena casi igual.
Head.
Head, es head.
Head. Okay. Head. Yeah, number one is head. Head. Se pronuncia.
Brown. ¿Ah? No, oh, solo está. Oí que dijo que qué color era el pelo.
Ah, no. No quería decir este head. La pronunciación de head es como solo como una E. Head.
Head.
Yep. Okay. Next. What is number two? And it is not her hair. So, Paloma, what is number two? Do you know how to say, oh, no te escucho, I can't hear you, but do you know how to say hombro, Paloma? No sé si pusiste el teléfono en mudo a propósito o accidente.
No, no, no te escucho. No, no, como a propósito.
Ah,
parece que usted lo pone como en mudo, t-shirt.
Ah, no te entendí, perdón.
Que siempre, casi siempre me parece como que usted desactiva el audífono y tengo que volver a activarlo.
Ajá. Oh, no creo que lo desactivé esta vez. Pero cuando hay mucho ruido, a veces lo pongo en uh-huh. mudo. Pero, disculpe, no quería decirlo. But how uh-huh. do you say hombro?
¿Hombro?
Yeah.
No, me doy. No sé cuál es.
Ok. Hombro.
Estudié todo, pero los hombros no recuerdo haber estudiado hombro.
That's okay. Shoulder.
Shoulder.
Yeah. Hombro, shoulder.
Déjame la apunto.
Yeah.
Porque no lo tenía uh-huh. ese apuntado. Uh-huh.
Yeah, creo que esto no era uno de las que practicamos la semana.
Ajá, no venía.
Shoulder, hombro. Okay, hombro. Number three, Danny.
Hombro.
How do you say pecho?
Chest?
Yeah. Chest.
Okay.
Good. Okay, Aide, number four.
Number four
and
that is arm.
Arm. Good. That is the arm. Okay, Paloma, number five.
Elbow.
It's elbow.
Elbow.
Good. Codo is elbow. All right, Danny, number six.
¿Es como la mano?
Yeah.
¿A hand?
Hand.
Hand, okay.
Okay. Now, Number seven, Aide. How do you say muñeca?
Muñeca?
Yeah.
No, me voy.
No, muñeca no.
Muñeca.
So, fingers, unos dedos, no finger.
So, dedos or dedo finger. Is finger.
Finger.
Dedos, sí. Yes, dedo is finger. But aquí referimos a la muñeca. La parte entre la mano y el brazo se llama wrist.
Wrist.
Wrist. Muñeca, wrist.
¿Lo escribe, por favor?
Yeah. Es esta aquí. Wrist. W-R-I-S-T. Oh, yes. Pero la W es silenciosa.
Wrist.
Wrist.
Wrist. Okay.
Wrist. Okay. Number eight. Number eight, Paloma.
Stomach?
Stomach.
Stomach.
Good. Pero la CH a veces hace el sonido de la K. En este caso, sí. Stomach.
Stomach. Okay.
Good. Okay. Danny, what is number nine?
Leg?
So, not her leg, it's this part right here.
Okay. Entonces, so, knee.
Good, it's her knee.
Okay, rodilla.
Yeah, rodilla is knee.
Knee. Knee.
Okay.
Yeah, la K silenciosa, y es... super común que la doble E en inglés hace el sonido I. Esa letra en inglés se llama I.
Ni.
Ni.
Okay.
Good. Okay, number 10, Aide.
Leg.
That is her leg.
Panturrilla.
Huh?
Panturrilla. Leg
is pierna.
Pierna,
yeah.
Ay, la pierna yo la tengo más arriba.
oh, bueno, yeah, la imagen no es perfecta. Pantorrilla se llama calf.
Calf.
Es un calf con F, es un poco más específico. Calf. Comenzamos calf. Con las partes más comunes. Yeah, calf. Okay, so now, Aloma, number 11 and number 12.
Es el pie, ¿verdad?
So,
the line is,
one of them is pie. How do you say pie?
What?
Foot.
Foot.
Foot. Yeah. So number 12 is foot.
Foot.
Pie. And number 11?
Tail. Tail.
Tail.
Nope. Oh, ¿qué dijeron? ¿Qué? Que solo queda una opción. There's only one choice left.
Ankle.
Ankle is tobillo. Tobillo.
Ankle es tobillo.
Yeah, ankle.
Ankle.
So, la parte atrás se llama heel, el talón, heel. But el tobillo es ankle. La articulación, la junta, es el ankle. Y otro ejemplo de L-E al final de una palabra es O. No es le, como en español, ankle, ankle.
Ankle, ok.
Podemos ponerlo al lado de palabras como table, comfortable, bowl, table, comfortable, ankle, O. Es como O-L. Okay. Any questions?
Okay. How do you say dedos?
Fingers.
Fingers?
Fingers.
Okay.
Dedos, fingers.
¿Y un dedo finger?
Un dedo finger.
Okay.
Dedos de pie, toes.
Toes.
Tenemos palabras distintos en inglés por esto, por esas cosas. Toes.
So, how did you write?
So, can you see it here? Toes. T-O-E-S.
Okay, sounds good.
Dedo de pie, okay. Toes en plural. Son plurales normales, la singular solamente no lleva la S. So, toe,
T-O-E. Wow, ya me
ha tenido
llamado. Okay. So, what's wrong? Para decir que algo nos duele, my, lo que sea, hurts. So,
hurts.
No, yeah. My stomach hurts. My hand hurts. So let's see. Number one, Danny, what do you say? Finish the sentence.
My head hurts.
Yeah. My head hurts.
Yo tengo una pregunta, teacher.
Sure.
Digamos, en ese caso también nos sirve la palabra pain.
No, porque pain es dolor. Sería como decir, mi cabeza dolor.
Oh, okay.
No tiene sentido. My head hurts es mi cabeza duele. Porque doler es un verbo. Dolor es la idea de algo que nos duele. Es una cosa que nos duele. Pues aquí necesitamos un verbo. My head hurts.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. All right. Number two, Aide.
My heart hurts.
Oh, here it's my arm hurts.
My arm hurts.
Yeah, I heard my heart hurts. Como mi corazón, my heart hurts. Es lo que escuché.
Ah, no, pero no me duele.
Okay, that's good. My arm hurts. My arm hurts.
My arm hurts.
Good. Okay, Paloma, number three.
¿Es espalda o codo?
Espalda.
¿Y what do you say, espalda?
How do you say espalda? Espalda is back.
Back. Back. Okay, my back hurts. ¿Cómo se dice? Hurts.
My back hurts. Good.
My back hurts. Mm-hmm. Back, espalda, ¿verdad?
Back, espalda. Okay. Number four, Danny, what's wrong?
What's the number?
Number four.
My stomach hurts.
Good. My stomach hurts.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, Aide, number five. What's wrong?
My hair. Mano es caro, ¿no? Hair?
No, mano, hand.
Hand. My hand hurt.
Good. My hand hurts.
My hand hurt.
My hand hurts. Okay. Number six, Paloma.
My cane hurts.
So, si fuera rodilla, recuerda que la K es silenciosa. My knee.
My knee.
My knee hurts.
My knee hurts.
Aquí la presentación dice leg, pierna. Es más cerca a la pierna que la rodilla.
Okay.
My leg hurts.
My leg.
Si fuera rodilla es knee, pierna, leg. Okay. Number seven, Danny, what's wrong?
My foot hurts.
My foot hurts. Okay. Y eso es como decimos que un pie duele. Mi pie duele. Un pie. Now, Es un poco diferente. Oops. Por los dos. How do you say me duelen los pies?
Como era esa la sabía. Let me think. Es como feet.
Feet.
Feet. Feet. Yeah.
My feet.
My feet hurt.
Yeah, my feet hurt. Yeah. So.
Feet es como para los dos patas. Digo,
para los pies. Los dos pies, las dos patas. Sí.
Sorry.
That's good. One foot is un pie. Two feet, dos pies.
Okay.
Es un plural irregular. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, good. Okay. Next, talking to the pharmacist. Let's see. Hi, what's wrong, Aide?
My hair, ¿cómo se me dificulta eso?
That's not bad. That's good. My head hurts.
My hair hurts.
Yeah, my head hurts. Okay. Are you allergic to any medicine? Oh, sorry.
Sí, estoy esperando. No, I am not.
Okay. Take 2 Tylenol and drink a lot of water. All right. Any questions about this dialogue?
No.
Okay. Talking to the cashier. I need to buy some Tylenol, Danny.
That will be $5.99. Plus tax for a total of $6.25.
Good. So yeah, you can say that will be $5.99. No más los números, está bien. Oh, los dos, right? You say that will be $5.99, or that will. Decimos no más los números, o decimos dólares y centavos, right? That'll be $5.99, like you said at the end. $6.25.
Una pregunta, teacher. ¿Cuál es el otro significado de dollars, de dólares, aparte de dollars?
Ah, la otra palabra.
Yeah, la otra palabra.
Bucks.
Bucks. Oh,
bucks.
Yes.
Yeah. That's a good question. $5 is igual a $5.
Is it same?
Yeah, it's the same.
Okay.
So, por ejemplo, para esta próxima parte, yo digo, here is $10, or here is $10.
Okay.
So here is $10.
Okay.
Next part, Danny. Here is $10.
Me escucha. Thank you. Here is your change. $3.75.
So you say it. In vez de dollars, right? So $3.75.
Okay. Sí, porque los últimos son centavos.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you can say, thank you. Here's your change. $3.75.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
You too. You right. too. I hope you feel better.
I hope you feel better. Yeah. Okay. I hope you feel better. Espero que te sientas mejor. Okay. Better is mejor, right? Okay. So, let's practice. Pretend or imagine you are at the pharmacy and have the following problems. Okay? So, Paloma, what's wrong?
Digo lo que significa, lo más en lo que es.
So imagina que estás en la farmacia. Pues, imagine okay. You're at the pharmacy. What's wrong?
My, ¿cómo se dice? My leg hurts.
Yeah.
It hurts.
Hurts. Mi pierna duele. Yeah. Y es como mi pierna duele. Es como lo decimos en inglés. My leg hurts. Okay. Are you allergic to any medicine?
Yeah.
¿Tienes alergia? Are you allergic to any medicine?
Yes, ¿cómo se dice?
I am allergic.
I am allergic to
penicillin.
Penicillin.
Yes. Okay, yeah, good. Okay. That's no problem. Take 2 Tylenol and drink a lot of water and rest or sleep. Okay?
Okay.
All right, thank you. I am allergic to penicillin. All right. So next, Danny, you have this problem. So what's wrong? Oh, Danny Sikwe. Hi there. What's wrong?
Her.
Pero no decimos I am, como es como yo estoy o yo soy. Right? Hay otra manera en que decimos me duele el brazo.
Okay.
How do you say me duele el brazo?
Me duele el brazo.
Me duele el brazo. Right? So, es como mi brazo duele.
My arm hair.
Good. My arm hurts.
My arm hair.
Yeah. Hurts. TS al final. Hurts.
Hurt.
Yeah. Okay. Are you allergic to any medicine?
No. I'm not allergic to medicine.
Okay. Take 2 Tylenol and drink a lot of water. Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a nice day. All right. Thank you. Next, Paloma. What's wrong?
My hands. ¿Cómo se llama?
Hand.
My hands hurt.
Yeah, my hand hurts.
My hand.
Otra cosa que podemos agregar es tengo una cortada, tengo una corte. I have a cut.
I have a cut.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, good. Okay, you need bandages.
Oh no, I am allergic.
Oh, that's good. That's good. Yo tengo bandages son vendas o vendajes. Vendas?
Oh, okay. Vendas.
Okay, so you need bandages. Sería, tú necesitas vendas, right? You need bandages.
Oh. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, that will be $5.
Okay.
All right. Sorry?
Okay.
Yeah, you have to pay. It's not free. So, you need bandages.
It's very expensive.
Yeah, it's expensive in the United States. I could say you need bandages. Tú necesitas vendas.
Tú necesitas o yo necesito.
Yo necesito. I need that. Yo necesito eso.
Okay.
Yeah. So vendas are bandages or band-aids?
Band-aid
es la marca que los hace y es una marca tan popular, tan común que la gente refiere a la venda con el nombre de la marca. con mucha frecuencia. Pues vendas puede ser bandages o band-aids. Band-aids es la marca, pero es casi más común usar ese término. Como todos los Okay. Okay. Ade, what's wrong?
My knee hurts.
My knee hurts. Good. Okay. Are you allergic to any medicine?
No. I'm not allergic to medicine.
Okay. Take 2 Tylenol and get some sleep. Sleep a lot and you will feel better tomorrow.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Next, Aide. I mean, Paloma. Paloma, what's wrong?
A mí, ¿por qué?
Solo hay dos ahora.
Why?
Only you.
Okay. ¿Cómo se cabeza? My head.
Good, head.
My head hurts.
Good, my head hurts. Okay. Are you allergic to Tylenol?
Yes.
Oh, no. Okay, you need ibuprofen. So take 2 ibuprofen and drink a lot of water.
Okay, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Good. And the last one, Ive. What's wrong?
My foot hurts.
Okay. Well, take 2 Tylenol and sleep. And tomorrow, I hope you feel better.
Okay, thank you.
All right, good. Next. So new, getting sick. Enfermándose. Decimos getting sick.
Getting sick.
Yeah. So let's talk about getting sick and how to get help. A common cold, or el resfriado común, a common cold may have the following symptoms and over-the-counter solutions. So, symptom, a runny nose, a stuffy nose, some congestion. A solution, use nasal spray. Okay? So, a runny nose is como una nariz corriente, o que corre, es que el líquido sale. Está corriendo. A runny nose. Yeah. A stuffy nose es congestión. Stuffy, como congestionado.
Stuffy.
Yeah, so, y también tenemos esta palabra, some congestion. Es algo de congestión, o algún, un poco de congestión. Some congestion.
Congestion.
Yeah. Any questions here?
No.
Okay. Tos. A cough.
Cough.
La palabra se pronuncia como hay una F. A cough.
Cough.
Yeah. So, if you have a cough, you can take cough syrup. Right? If you have a cough, si tienes un tos, you can take cough syrup. So, tos, repeat after me, is cough.
Cough.
But yeah. Es porque el GH así, bueno, O-U-G-H, a veces se pronuncia como una F. Otro ejemplo es en la palabra laugh, como reír. Laugh, right? So cough, laugh, ejemplos de palabras en que GH es una F. No es súper común, pero existe este sonido. Okay. Next. A fever. So, a temperature of 99 degrees or more is a fever.
A fever.
Yeah, a fever. If you have a fever, you can take ibuprofen, and you need to sleep. You need to drink a lot of water and sleep. Okay. Yeah, so fiebre, a fever.
Fever.
Yeah, fever. Next is a sore throat. Okay. A sore throat is como garganta dolorosa.
Dolor de garganta.
Yeah, dolor de garganta is a sore throat. Una garganta irritada, más o menos. So if you have a sore throat, you can take throat lozenges. Lozenges, pastillas dulces, throat lozenges. Yeah, so repeat after me. A sore throat.
A sore throat.
Take throat lozenges.
Take
lozenges. Good. Take throat lozenges. Yeah. Okay. New, giving instructions. Okay. So giving instructions is dando instrucciones or mandatos. Commands. Son mandatos in English. Commands. So giving instructions or commands in English is simple. Just use the present tense form of the verb. So here is the command, el mandato, right? Take throat lozenges as needed. Tome pastillas dulces como necesitado, right? So siempre les recuerdo que en una declaración, una oración normal, comenzamos con el sujeto, right? I have a sore throat. Pero con mandatos, no hay un sujeto. Comenzamos el mandato con el verbo. Y es el verbo en la forma presente simple, right? Take throat lozenges as needed. Tome pastillas como necesitado. Okay? So, yeah, down here. Notice that there is no subject pronoun, right? No dice tú, tome, toma, tomes, tomas. No es nada así. Solo el verbo en base. This is the... Es el único caso en inglés en que no comenzamos o no identificamos el sujeto en la oración. Es en mandatos. ¿Ok?
Mm-hmm. Ok.
Ok. So, let's practice more. Pretend you are at the pharmacy and you have this problem. Aide, what's wrong?
I have a sore throat, garganta, throat.
Good. I have a sore throat.
I have sore throat.
Okay. So, para responder, yo digo, okay, take throat lozenges. Take throat lozenges and drink tea with lemon.
Okay.
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 All right. Next. Paloma, what's wrong?
I have refer.
Again, sorry?
I have a refer. Resfriado, ¿verdad?
Resfriado es la misma palabra para frío en inglés. I have a cold.
I have a cold.
Yeah, cold, como tengo un frío es como traduce. Pero recuerda, para decir tengo frío, es en inglés decimos I am cold. Right? Tengo frío. I am cold. Tengo frío. Pero tengo un resfriado. I have a cold.
I'm cold.
Okay. Yeah, good. Okay. Take cough syrup, maybe. So here, you can say, I have a cold, or I have some congestion. Algo de congestión.
Okay.
I have some congestion. Yeah. Oh, and you can, remember, ahora recuerdo la solución. Okay, use nasal spray. Spray de la nariz. Use nasal spray.
Spray nasal?
Yeah. Okay. Next, Aide, what's wrong?
I have fever.
I have a fever.
A fever.
Yeah. Yeah, it's como otra vez usamos a como un fiebre, una fiebre. I have a fever.
I have a fever.
Okay. Take ibuprofen. Drink a lot of water.
Okay.
I can say take 2 ibuprofen. You drink a lot of water and get a lot of rest. Okay? Okay. So rest is descanso.
Okay.
Get a lot of rest. Obtenga mucho descanso. Get a lot of rest. Todos son ejemplos de mandatos, en todos comienzan con el verbo y no tienen un sujeto en la oración. Take 2 ibuprofen, drink a lot of water, get a lot of rest.
With water or soda?
Water, no soda. Soda is bad. Do not drink soda.
Okay.
Good question. All right. Paloma, what's wrong?
I have a cough.
Cough. I have a cough. Okay. Take cough syrup.
Take cough syrup. I have cough.
So first, I have a cough. Tengo un tos. All right. Take cough syrup. Tome sirope de la tos. No sé. La medicina para es líquido productos. Take cough syrup. All right, good. So we have first, I have a sore throat, right? And then I have a cold, or I have some congestion. Right? I have a fever, and I have a cough. Right?
I have a cough. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So, here, we can say, I am sick. Estoy enfermo. I am sick. Sick is an enfermo.
Enfermo.
Yeah. And we can say, I am sick. Estoy enfermo. Or, I have a cold. Tengo un resfriado. So, there are different ways to talk about the same thing. Hay maneras diferentes de hablar de la misma cosa. There are different ways to talk about the same thing. So, let's practice. All right. Aide, what's wrong?
I am sick.
Okay. Y fill in the blank. Llena el blanco, el espacio. Fill in the blank. I'm sick. I have.
I am.
Okay.
A runny nose.
You can say, I have a cold. Tengo resfriado. But I have a runny nose. Quiero decir, tengo líquido saliendo de la nariz. I have a runny nose. Es como una nariz corriente. Algo así. No
traducido. Una nariz. Es que nosotros le decimos una nariz mocosa.
Pero esto no es como congestionado. Runny es cuando sigue goteando líquido.
Solo agua.
Líquido.
Solo agua.
Sí. Yeah. I have a runny nose. Sale líquido. No es congestión.
Okay. I have a runny nose.
I have a runny nose.
I am runny.
Yeah. Okay. Paloma, what's wrong?
I have a cough.
I have a cough. Good. Oh, that's true.
Me too. Verdad.
Okay. Aide, what's wrong?
I have a fever.
Yeah, I am sick. I have a fever. Oh, well. Aquí, tu respuesta está muy bien. Aquí dice, I have the flu. Tengo el gripe. I have the flu.
I have the flu.
No, I have the flu. I have a fever. I have a runny nose. I have a sore throat. Everything hurts.
Okay.
All right. Paloma, what's wrong?
I have a fever.
Good. I am sick. I have a fever.
Fever.
Okay. Ade, what's wrong?
I have strong.
I have a sore throat.
Sore throat.
Yeah. I am sick. I have a sore throat. Okay. Oh, here's one. Here's a new one. What's wrong, Paloma?
I have dolor de estómago.
Dolor de estómago is I have a stomach ache.
Stomach ache.
Yeah. Dos veces esta palabra tiene CH que se pronuncia como K. I have a stomach ache.
I have a stomach ache.
Okay.
Yeah, tengo dolor de estómago. ¿Estómago? I have a stomach ache. Thank you.
I have a stomach ache.
Yeah. And what's wrong?
I have cortar es cord.
I have a cut.
A cut. I have a cut.
Good. Cut. My hand hurts. I have a cut.
Yeah.
Okay, and Paloma, what's wrong?
I have. ¿Cómo se dice dolor de cabeza?
Es como dolor de estómago, pero. Cabeza en vez de estómago.
Head.
I have a headache.
A head.
My head hurts. I have a headache.
I hear. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. We will stop here today. Okay. Any questions for me before we say goodbye?
No, teacher. Okay.
All right. Pasa rápido el tiempo.
Yeah. It went by so fast, right? Yeah. That was a good class. Thank you both and have a good night.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.